videos of some important things that would see, or some things that would just ease my mind as I would be hard studying. Eventually, we all know that on YouTube, once you watch a certain video, it recommends another video. When you go to that video, it also recommends another video. So these videos would lead one video to another, one video to another, until finally I find myself in perhaps a video which has naked girls. That the video of naked girls would lead to another of light pornographic material. And I would keep on watching and watching until, I don't know what happened, find myself watching these videos which the Prophet talked about when he prophesied me. And again, this destroyed me a lot because, like I mentioned, it made me have a very strong sexual desire which would drive me into masturbation and which would make me, in fact, sleep with various girls. And in fact, some of them, I would impregnate them and would opt for an abortion. And this really destroyed my life because it left an emptiness inside of me. And again, when I moved to the Northwest University where I'm studying for my master's, I was enrolled in 2014. And the program was meant to last only for a year. And I had to complete that program in just 1 year. Very unfortunately, because the spirit was destroying me, as I'm speaking now, I was currently in my third year, and I'd been failing from the first year, second year, and third year I decided that no, I'm just going to take everything slowly and perhaps quit. And it really was destroying my career. And again, on my career as a lawyer, in my country, you are not allowed to advertise your services. Your services come recommended by the clients that you have already served. So the only way in which people can know about you and your services as a lawyer is that they know about you, they know that you are a dignified man, they know that they can trust you with their problems. Because in fact, we're actually dealing with real life problems, and people cannot just take their problems and then put them in the hands of somebody who is very reckless. Now, this spirit of smoking and drinking would make me lose my dignity and make some of my clients not to trust in me. Like it happened on some other occasions, they would bump into me at the drinking pubs, and you'd realize that they have lost hope in me and they do not trust me with their problems anymore. And in fact, it actually affected my career very negatively, and my practice was not growing at all. It was stuck in one place.
And can you also tell us how did this problem affect your family, your near ones, and people that you love?
This problem affected my family and the people that I love that are close to me very negatively. First, my relationship with my own father. It was becoming worse every day, and I would lose respect for him and I would become very stubborn. And this actually drove us apart. And again, my mother, she was the one who really cared for me and who really wanted to see me make something out of my life. And she would try everything in her power to make sure that my life comes together, that I quit with these things. But I wouldn't be able to. There are times when I would try to please her and try to quit and try to live a proper life. Like it happened, sometimes I would really quit for indeed. But unfortunately, after some time, I would revert back to these things without even me knowing how, in fact, I went back to that kind of a lifestyle again. And it really affected her because it brought a lot of depression on her, as she really wants to see something out of her children. And again, in my relationship with the lady that I'm currently dating, it really brought a wedge in between us because our relationship was based or founded on lies, because I would constantly lie to her. And then when I'm with her, I would say that, well, our relationship is a relationship of pleasing God. And while I would say that to her, I would sneak behind her back and then start doing all of these things that ultimately started to destroy my life. So my relationship with the people that I love was really a relationship of lies, a relationship of fightings and all negative things.
It was in the midst of all this turmoil that you now decided to come to the Synagogue Church for Nations, and glory be to Jesus Christ, the Spirit of God located you last Sunday. Can you tell us, when you received that message of prophecy and you received your deliverance, what happened, how did you feel, and how are you feeling after that?
I would like to first explain how I came to the Synagogue Church of All Nations. My mother has always been watching Emmanuel TV and encouraging us on a daily basis that we should watch it and we should pray along with the prophet. But I normally never really got interested in Emmanuel TV until recently, when I felt that maybe it's time that I should visit the Synagogue Church of All Nations, and we made a decision that I come. And the reason was that I was failing in my studies, my law firm was not growing, and I was becoming forgetful, and my career, instead of growing, seemed to be going down. So we decided, well, let me go. Perhaps the man of God will give me a solution. And the funny thing is that when I came here, I thought that my problem emanated from something else, or maybe from the spirit of witches, or an ancestral spirit, or any other negative attitude, only to find that when the man of God approached me and then started prophesying to me that the devil had been using me as a weapon against myself. The devil was using me to destroy myself. And when the man of God prophesied to me, I got delivered indeed, because all that he said to me was true.
Now let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So can you now tell us, after your deliverance, how are you now?
After my deliverance, I feel very light. My heart is free, my spirit is free. I'm happy, and I normally had people giving testimonies and then saying, that night I slept like a baby. For the first time in my life, I understood what they meant when they said that they slept like a baby, because the night after my deliverance, I slept like a baby, and I felt free indeed. And the edge is gone. And normally when I'd taken an effort on my own to quit, I would always be scared of the future, of whether indeed I had quit. But now I feel a certain level of confidence, and that indeed I am free and delivered and not scared of the future or the people that I used to do these things with, whether they'll drive me back or not. I'm not worried about that. All I'm worried about now is that I maintain my relationship with God.
All right, let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. We thank God for this wonderful testimony of how God Almighty really used this message of prophecy to turn your situation around, put you out of the kingdom of darkness and put you back into the kingdom of light. And finally, there are many people that are watching you. They may have found themselves in similar challenges and situations that you once found yourself in. Can you just give them a word of advice concerning their lives and the solution that you yourself found?
My word of advice to people out there is that never underestimate a demon in your life. Never assume that just because you feel that your challenge is a little one or a challenge that you can handle, that it is nothing. Because for me, this challenge was never a part of my problem. I never even thought that the root cause of my problem was this. And this is affecting many people out there, because a lot of people are on the internet on a daily basis. A lot of people interact with other people out there, and there's a lot of challenges of this nature. And all I can say to people out there is that do not tempt the devil to tempt you, because the minute you tap into these things, they will entangle you and they will tie you down so much that you won't even know what has happened to you. All you'll remember is that your life was still proper, and all of a sudden things are starting to fall apart. And that people should really be careful on what they view with their eyes, because the devil is out there roaring like a lion and in search to devour everyone that he meets or comes across. And he uses every device and every aspect that he can get or lay his hands on in order to entangle people's God and take their lives into captivity. So people out there should really care on what they view on the internet, on the nature of relationships that they have, and on the things that they do generally, that they don't find themselves tempted by the devil or find themselves tempting the devil in order to tempt them.
Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ once again. So finally, now I want to encourage you to continue running the straight race through God's good grace. Make sure that you make God's word the standard for your life so that this wonderful testimony that you have in your life today will continue to increase and multiply as the days go on in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Nous venons d'écouter le témoignage de cet homme qui a reçu une prophétie de l'homme de Dieu, le prophète Divi Joshua, qui lui disait qu'il souffrait d'addiction à la pornographie, à la masturbation, d'addiction à la cigarette et à l'alcool. Il explique comment, en faisant des recherches pendant ses études, il déviait ses recherches sur des sites pornographiques et comment finalement tout cela a impacté sa carrière universitaire. Il dit même qu'en tant qu'avocat, il a aussi perdu beaucoup de clients qui ont perdu confiance en lui. Au niveau familial, ses relations avec ses parents se sont beaucoup dégradées et il vivait continuellement dans le mensonge. Et c'est à la recherche de solutions qu'il est venu à la synagogue église de toutes les nations, où il a reçu le message prophétique et sa délivrance pour la gloire de Dieu. Aujourd'hui, il dit qu'il se sent libre avec un cœur léger et un esprit léger. Il peut aussi dormir tranquillement. Cette envie et cette luxure a complètement disparu. Il conseille à tous de ne pas tenter le diable pour vous tenter et de se tourner vers Jésus. Il remercie Dieu pour sa vie.
Continuamos más con una confirmación de la palabra profética que sucedió el domingo pasado aquí en la sinagoga iglesia de todas las naciones. Nos comenta este joven, él viene desde el país de Lesoto, está en el continente africano, en el cual nos comenta que él sufría demasiados problemas en su carrera debido a una adicción. El profeta TV Joshua, en cierto, le dijo que tenía una adicción al internet, a pornografía, a desnudarse, tomarse fotografías e intercambiarlas, y que esta lujuria le llegaba hasta masturbarse, inclusive estando sentado. Él confirma esta profecía, comentando la trayectoria de su vida, que esto ha afectado realmente su carrera como abogado, puesto que este sin frenar de apetito sexual hacia las personas, a las mujeres, le llevaba a involucrarse con clientes y esto bajar su respeto y además falta de credibilidad en su carrera como abogado. También esto le llevaba a fumar y a tomar también desenfrenadamente, también afectando su familia, perdiendo total respeto hacia su padre y también a su madre, que era quien lo cuidaba, y además afectar su relación con una prometida, en el cual se basó con puras mentiras, siendo que él era infiel y se acostaba con muchas personas fuera de su relación. Él nos comenta que después de esta palabra profética está completamente libre, puesto que después de esta liberación no siente ningún apetito sexual hacia nada, el deseo de ver internet se ha terminado y hoy nos encuentra estar libre. También esto le afectó a su carrera porque no podía terminar su maestría, siendo que él debía haberlo terminado en un año y son 3 años en el cual se encuentra atrapado en estas circunstancias debido a la falta de concentración, que como pretexto iba al internet, en YouTube, en videos para investigar acerca de su carrera, pero finalmente se encontraba viendo videos pornográficos. Pero hoy, gracias a Dios, a esta palabra profética, está completamente libre de este problema de lujuria y de pornografía. Gloria a Dios. Un testimonio más y confirmación de profecía por parte del profeta TV Joshua. Continuamos.
What God Almighty is about to do in our midst as we expect the arrival of Prophet TB Joshua very shortly. So one more time, let's watch the screens of our television and see what happened last week here in the Synagogue Church of All Nations as Prophet TB Joshua was moving around the congregation in a time of prophecy.
During the Synagogue Church of All Nations Sunday service, Prophet TB Joshua, guided by the Spirit of God's leading, moves amongst the international visitors and is used as a channel of freedom where there is bondage. Watch as the Spirit of God arrests any spirit of darkness in the life of this man and is used as a mouthpiece of God to speak to his life, to point him to his future success.
I have to treat the spirit like that. If I allow him to come out, he may be a bit arrogant and proud. Come on. Can you move? Yes. That spirit of loss is gone. It has destroyed your secular home.
Yes, sir.
They attack you in the dream. A woman attacks you, says, then you can't control yourself. When they come, you cannot listen well.
What man of God is saying is very true. We've even just divorced with my wife. I have a letter in the fire.
You have a letter of divorce?
Yeah.
Clap for Jesus Christ. The spirit of loss that's about to scatter his family is gone.
This is the divorce letter. This is my family.
See, beautiful family. There's nothing like that. We are going to discuss. I'm going to call your wife. Okay?
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. So we thank God Almighty for that wonderful word of prophecy that our brother received last week here at the Synagogue Church of All Nations. So right now we're going to listen to our brother, and as he shares his experiences, how he can confirm that word of prophecy to be true. So brother, you're welcome. Please introduce yourself to us. Tell us your name and where you are from.
People of God, Emmanuel. My name is Gawera Solomon. I'm from Uganda. Last Sunday, I was one of the people who attended the service, and man of God gave me a prophecy saying, I have the spirit of lust and the spiritual woman, and this spirit of lust has destroyed my settled marriage. I confirm the prophecy to be true, 100% true, because immediately when man of God talked of the spirit of lust and spiritual woman, I pulled out the letter to confirm that I had separated with my wife. Now I'm here to confirm the prophecy man of God gave me. At the age, it all started at the age of 16 years. I was in a secondary school, senior two. It was lunchtime. After eating lunch, I went and rested on a desk. As I was resting on a bench, then a spirit entered me. That spirit entered me, and it had an affair with me sexually. Then from there I developed the spirit of lust. And
okay, at this point we just want to stop our brother as he's given the explanation, the confirmation of this prophetic word. We all witnessed on the clips earlier how God used Prophet TB Joshua last week to address the case of our brother, and the brother mentioned that because of this spirit of lust and the spiritual wife, he had just divorced his wife. He even had the letter of divorce with him. And by the special grace of God, the wife of our brother is in the congregation today. She's in our midst by the special grace of God. And at this point, we want to leave the matter of our brother until Prophet TB Joshua comes out, and Prophet TB Joshua will attend to this case. So we're going to stop this issue right now, knowing that God Almighty is involved, and definitely we know that the opinion of God will be heard concerning the issue on ground. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ.
Vous venez d'écouter une rapide confirmation de prophétie de l'homme de cet homme à qui l'homme de Dieu lui a dit qu'il avait un esprit d'addiction sexuelle et que cela a failli briser son mariage. Il confirme à quel point cela était vrai et nous attendons que l'homme de Dieu, le prophète TB Joshua, puisse venir tout à l'heure pour régler cette affaire.
Continuons avec l'étape de prophétie, donde este hombre nos comenta exactamente el domingo pasado recibir palabra profética por parte del profeta TV Joshua acerca de un espíritu de arrogancia, de lujuria, de orgullo que había destrozado, de hecho, su matrimonio con ataques satánicos de una mujer espiritual. Él viene a confirmar esa profecía, pero unos momentos más, por gracia de Dios, el profeta TV Joshua va a comentar este caso personalmente, así es que manténgase pendiente para continuar con esta confirmación de profecía, libertad y sanidad en nombre poderoso de Jesucristo y restauración de matrimonio. Así es que manténgase pendiente, en unos momentos más el profeta TV Joshua vendrá entre la congregación. Gracias.
Almighty.